Stefan, just briefly, what is prime turning from Sandvik Coromant?
Basically, prime turning consists of three parts. It's a new method where you use the small entering angle to dramatically increase the output from the machine, cut the cycle time. It is also new tools and inserts for the application. And since it's a new method, it requires reprogramming and software to do that.
And what are the benefits of this strategy?
By the smaller entering angle, you can drastically increase the feed rates because of the chip thinning in effect, and the fact that you also spread the load and the heat over a longer part of the cutting edge allows you to significantly increase tool life.
And what sectors are we looking at for this application? I know there's obviously automotive shaft work, but this is far from easy material.
Today we're running on a duplex stainless steel, and you know it's not easy. Today we're also running it dry, so it makes it even more complicated to get ship control. So oil and gas components, aerospace components, those are the ones where you can have really big gains in tool life and time savings.
So would it be fair to say the harder the material, the better it is?
It is, yeah. Of course, a time saving for an automotive industry of 1 second could be huge, but the more tricky material you have, the bigger gains you will get.
And I understand the software is easy to use, so let's go and take a look.
Yeah, sure, we'll do. The ToolPath software is a cloud-based software, so you can enter it from our website, either to take a subscription or a 30 days trial period. So this is the place you land on, and you can choose to create a project, a new one, or a new from template, like an example program, just to show how it works. And then you can name your project as you like. And today we will do an external turning operation. We will do a roughing cut. And we can also define your machine. Either you use the default machine or you store your own machine library. Today we will run it on a DMG Mori. So you can select some power limitations, RPM limitations, and type of NC to generate. And also where your tool is located in the turret. From there you go on to the component. So these two are the input tabs. And here you can either import files or you can define them by coordinates. So here we have, let's say the yellow part is the profile that we will machine today. But you can also then import your blank.
What file formats can you import?
Both for the drive curve and for the stock or the blank, you can import file formats in basically all the 2D curves, step files, IGS files, DXF curves, but you can also use G71 or NC coordinates as an input. Or you can define your own, draw your own blank by coordinates input. And here you also select the material you're about to machine. Today we're running on a duplex stainless steel. And when you filled in those two input steps, the rest should come from the system. So it generates a recommendation of grade and geometry. Today we will run a new L3 geometry that is brand new for prime turning, prime A. And then we go further to the toolpath. At this stage it's empty fields, so we have to start by defining the cutting data, but very soon the system will provide start values for cutting data. So we will run 0.4 in feed, 175 meters, 2 millimeter depth of cut. And also the specific entry is quite important for prime turning to have a smooth entry into the component. So those are the input steps you do. And from here, the system will generate a toolpath. And before you get the NC code, you will have to run the simulation just to verify that you're not having a collision. And for example, I can go back here and change the depth of cut to 1.5 millimeter. And if you're used to CNC programming, you know how much job it is to make a new program by changing the depth of cut. But here we have a new program generated. We run the simulation, and then it starts automatically to generate NC code.
So how do you get the code to the machine tool?
Yeah, you simply download it, save it to file, and then either transfer it to the machine over the network if you have one, or simply a USB stick to the machine. So now we can play the simulation, see how it runs. And you can also follow it in the NC code. Stop anywhere you like, run it block by block, or go back in the NC code.
Just to conclude, what type of CNC machinist should adopt this strategy?
Yeah, anyone who is looking for a stable process but significantly increasing productivity, they will have a huge gain from prime turning, both in productivity and tool life. And as we spoke about before, the more tricky material you have and the longer time in cut, the bigger gains you will get. And from the software, this is aimed for users that don't have CAM software with prime turning support, or the ones doing shop floor programming to make life easier.